You already know large language models, or LLMs. They predict the next token in a sequence using a statistical pattern matching technique to crank out human-like text. There's also LRMs, large reasoning models, and they go a bit further. They think before they talk. Now, given LLM a prompt and it will projectile predict whatever word statistically fits next. It will output a token and then another token and then another token. And LRMs, they still do that too, but they sketch out a plan, they weigh options and they double check calculations in a sandbox before building their response. So before they start outputting tokens, they will plan, they will evaluate what comes back, and eventually that will lead to an answer. And those extra steps, they can matter. Now, if your question is to write a fun social media post, well, an LLM's reflex is usually fine. But if your question is debug this gnarly stack trace, or perhaps it's trace my cash flow through four different shell companies, well, reflex isn't enough. The LRM's internal chain of thought lets it test hypotheses and discard dead ends and land on a reasoned answer rather than just following a statistically likely pattern. Now, of course, this doesn't come for free. It costs inference time and GPU dollars each extra pass through the network, each self-check, each search branch. It all adds latency and processing time. So LRMs, they buy you deeper reasoning at the cost of a longer, pricier think. So how do you build one of these thinking machines? Well, an LRM usually builds upon an existing LLM that has undergone a set of massive pre-training. So this is the stage where we teach a model about the world. So billions of web pages, books, code repos, and the like. And this gives it language skills and a broad knowledge base. And then after the pre-training, an LRM undergoes specialized reasoning-focused tuning. So we're now going to fine-tune the model specifically to provide reasoning capabilities. So an LRM, it's fed curated data sets of logic puzzles and multi-step math problems and tricky coding tasks. And each one of those examples comes with a full chain of thought answer key, and the model learns to show its work. So it basically starts with a problem that it's been given, and from that problem, its job is to come up with a plan for a solution. Once it's come up with a plan, it needs to execute that plan, which will be in multiple steps. So we might go to step one, step two, and so forth. And then ultimately, the model needs to arrive at a solution. It's learning to reason. Then we let the model loose, trying to solve some fresh problems of its own. And that's where it goes through a process of reinforcement learning. Now, that uses a reward system where either humans, through reinforcement learning from human feedback, so RLHF, they give thumbs up or thumbs down for each one of these steps as they're written. Or the reinforcement learning can come from smaller models that are really judging models, like process reward models. And process reward models judge each step of a reasoning chain as good or as bad. And the reasoning model learns via this reinforcement learning to generate sequences of thoughts that maximize these thumbs up rewards, ultimately improving its logical coherence. Now, there are some other training methods that can be used as well. For example, we might choose to use something called distillation to train the model further. And that's where we have a larger teacher model that's used to generate reasoning traces. And then those reasoning steps are used to train a smaller model or a newer model on those traces. So Basically, if the advanced teacher model can solve a puzzle by thinking through a solution, that solution path can then be added to the training data of the new LRM model. And the result of all of this is a model that can plan, that can verify, and that can explain, ready to finally make sense of those shell company cash flows. So the LRM is trained to think, and now the question is, how much thinking time do you give it at runtime? Well, that's a question all about inference time, or test time as it's sometimes called, compute. This is what happens every time you ask a question, and different questions can be assigned different amounts of thinking time. So debug my stack trace, that might get a good amount of compute allowance, while write a fine caption, that kind of gets the budget version where the model just goes through one quick pass. And during extended inference time, a model may run multiple chains of thought, then it might vote on the best one, it might backtrack with a tree search if it hits a dead end, and it might call external stuff like a calculator or a database or a code sandbox for spot checks. And each extra pass through the model, well, it comes at a cost. It comes at a cost of more compute that is needed. It comes at a cost of how long you're going to be waiting for a response with higher latency. But hopefully this all does come also with an increase in accuracy, higher accuracy. So is this accuracy up arrow worth the cost to get it? Well, it depends on the problem you're trying to solve. Now, on the positive side, an LRM offers complex reasoning. LRMs excel at tasks that require multi-step logic planning or abstract reasoning. They also offer improved decision-making because LRMs can internally verify and deliberate, which means their answers tend to be a bit more nuanced and hopefully more accurate. And LRMs, they usually require less in the way of prompt engineering. We don't need to sprinkle in magic words in our prompting, like let's think step by step, because the model already does it. That's less prompt hackery. But you might be better off with a regular LLM or just a smaller model overall in some situations, because as I've mentioned, there is that higher computational cost. That means more VRAM, more energy, higher invoice price from your cloud provider. And then there's also the increase in latency, slower replies while the model stops to think. Although I'm endlessly kind of amused by reading those replies, the model's thinking steps as it works through building a response. But that's probably just me. So look, with LRMs, AI models are no longer just spewing language out at you as fast as they can predict the next word in a sentence. They are taking time to think through responses. And today, the most intelligent models, the ones scoring highest on AI benchmarks, well, they tend to be the reasoning models, the LRMs.